Welcome to this presentation. My name is Professor Rocco Lupoi and I am the Stream Director of the Engineering Wind Management course in Trinity College Dublin. And with this short video, I would like to introduce the course content. What is engineering from the general perspective? Well, think about a car, think about a building, think about a wind turbine, or think about an aircraft, for example. These are all examples of great pieces of technologies that engineers have been able to develop. So if you are with me on this, you're certainly listening to the right presentation. So if you want to get involved with engineering in Trinity College Dublin, there are a few options. One of them is to follow the main path. So your first 2 years are common for all type of engineering, and then you specialize in year three, four, and five. Or there is a very special degree called Engineering Wind Management, which is the one I'm focusing my attention right now, whereby we all start together from scratches, from year one, committed to a single team. And it's a very special degree because we only take 20 to 30 people in year one. So you will be able to really develop interactions, close up interaction with your colleagues and with your lectures that you wouldn't be able to do if you would be going through the main path. In particular, I like to emphasize the mechanical engineering side of the main engineering. So what's mechanical engineering? It's a diverse profession that lies at the crossroads of all engineering disciplines. It is indeed the broadest of all engineering. And I will agree with these definitions. And maybe I can follow on right now with some examples on work, that have been taken on from mechanical engineering after taking a degree. So for example, you have several career options from wind energy. So you'll be able, mechanical engineers are really responsible for the designs of wind turbines, how the blades are going to perform, what kind of power comes in from the wind, and how much power you can take out in electricity. They can also get heavily involved in civil constructions. It's a little bit controversial to say that, but it is true. If you're interested in this, that is correct. Down to the automotive industry, which is somehow colonized really by mechanical engineers. So you can see here a couple of pictures from a sport car on the left, and on the right-hand side is the new concept Tesla, electric truck that is going to come through quite soon. And at the base of these particular developments lays around the hard work of engineers. That's for sure the case. Down to maybe on the left, you see an example of 3D printing, which is maybe you heard about these new ways of making stuff, whereby following a 3D strategy, a layer by layer construction, such as you can see from the video on your left. And we'll have a lot of courses that will pretty much specialize on this particular technology. Down to the right, so we also build quite an extensive array of interfaces in production lines, for example, through the help of robots. So if you're interested in robotics, you are also, in the right place in this particular scope. On the left now is another example. If you like space and aerospace, also engineering and mechanical engineering will give you a great deal of competence. What you see on the left is a very controversial, unnatural looking landing of the Falcon Heavy from SpaceX. These are the boosters of the rocket, and technology has so much developed that they can actually land on Earth without having to collect those in the middle of the ocean, as it used to be only some years ago. Down to the right-hand side, which is more the work of sophisticated control engineers and autopilot modes, whereby people here, engineers, are really designing control systems that are able to replace really the human when driving under certain conditions, for example. Down, if you're also interested in helping humans, that's what also is the right path to follow for sure. So robotics is a topic that is important for engineering and specifically addressed quite well in the Engineering Wind Management course. So you can see here how we develop at the moment, our research as a PhD students and And professors on this topic are helping people with problems and disabilities with technology to do tasks that would be very difficult for them to perform otherwise. A little bit of history, maybe in our school as a whole. Okay, we have here a very special course called Engineering with Management, but we are still attached to the main school of engineering as a whole, which was founded in 5992, so it's a really old one in a way. And we have in our building, in the Parsons building that you see in the picture, 21 full academy staff members, about 23 postdoc researchers. These are research people that will do all the work, all the developmental work, for the newest technology you will see in the future. And you guys will have the chance to interact, on a one-by-one basis with these very smart people. And we have also a very diverse range of research and technical expertise, down from robotics to manufacturing to fluid dynamics to materials, for example, to aerospace design. There is plenty there available for you guys to be involved on. So here's the core structure, and specifically tailored for the engineering with management. So what's the difference really between the main engineering stream, maybe the main mechanical engineering stream, and the engineering with management degree? Well, straight from year one, first of all, as I said before, the class is really small, so interaction with colleagues and lecturers are really possible, and I really would like to emphasize the importance of those for your education and for your professional development. This is a big plus that your colleagues from the other stream will not be able to avail of. But in addition to that, we also add on some business and management modules straight from year one, follow on to year two, then to year four and year three and year four, and eventually year five, if you want to progress to a master type of degree. Business and management are very important topic for an engineer. If you look out there, all the main company CEOs, I'm talking about very important and rich people out there, have an engineering background. So managing a business, how the way it works, so that can also translate directly into managing a technology or a new technology. And we have a lot of experience on this through our company, collaborators and partners, through our professors, through our research projects. And we want really to transfer the knowledge straight from year one to you guys. So you guys will get to year four or five with a great technical, with a sound technical education, but with the additional of entrepreneurship that this course is going to really give it to you. This is just an example also of the cluster of collaborators we have, and you'll be able, for example, in year three to go out with an Erasmus program to do some modules in other universities in Europe, for example, in Turin or in the Netherlands, in TU Delft or in UCL or in Germany. These are just examples. In year four, you also be able to opt for an internship, so to work for about 6 months for a company, really, and we value that very much. That will give you a great deal of experience in how a company setup looks like and how that compares versus an academic setup that you probably were used to very much, but not so much to the new company background. And usually what I see from the past is if you do a good job in your internship, and again, it's an optional thing, it's not really a compulsory one, then, but if you decide to take that on, if you do a good job, the company will come back to you and it will try to give you a full offer after you finish your degree. So it's a kind of good way to really find new contacts that could represent in the near future your potential employers really effectively. Not least, we have also a program called Unitech that really allows you to get a double degree, okay, which is an important thing. I really emphasize the importance, and the option we offer for you guys to step outside of your comfort zone here in your hometown, maybe in your home university, and go take some modules, for example, in Milan or in the Netherlands, and take an exam there and take a double degree, which employers really, really value. that opens your door quite widely. Not from the technical perspective, but from the managerial perspective. You're seen as having, another gear once you are successful in another country, taking modules and exams at the same time, and also in your own country. So, and we got this option, these options that you guys will be able to avail of if you want to, of course. Some examples also, on current research project that we have, successfully executed. And as you know, 20% of global population lack access to electricity. Think about Africa, lots of locations whereby electric power is really not an option to get access to easily. And we have developed here as an example a very simple way that will allow you to, or a person that has no access to electricity, to easily charge their phones or your phone, for example, by using just stoves. So cooking stoves are widely common in central part of Africa. And now we develop for these guys a way, a very simple way, with a few, electronics. You join them up together, you have a stove that you use for cooking mainly, but you will be able to generate electricity that is enough to charge your phone. And that is a great step stone in our opinion. We really had these people in Central Africa in this stage. Down to maybe developing a new manufacturing process here. You see a process that we have developed here called cold spray. Without going to do too much in the detail of that, you can Google it to find out a lot of more information. But it's an additive way, it's a metal coating process. Down also to development of very advanced robotics. So if you also want to get involved into this, right from year two up to year five, we have a great team here that really is very competent around the development of human type of robots. They are designed there really to help, again, humans to perform certain tasks that they wouldn't really be able to do so in reality. So if you like this topic, there will be plenty of potential for you guys to get involved on. I would like to thank you for your attention. I hope you enjoyed this short presentation. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to drop me an email at the address below. Thank you very much.